בוקר טוב לכולם. ברוכים הבאים ליום עיון ה-11 בתיאוריה של מדעי המחשב. אני אדבר אנגלית. Good morning and welcome to the 11th edition of the Israeli CS Theory Day here at the Open University, and thank you all for coming. The tradition of the CS Theory Day started more than 10 years ago in March 2008, and this year I was lucky enough to have the honor of organizing the 11th edition of the day. A while ago, while talking to some researcher, he told me that these theory days at the Open University have already become a canonic event, which people in the theory CS community in Israel come ready for every year, because that's what people do. And that was a very heartwarming remark. And I think it also reflects the importance that these days have gained over the years, and the reputation, both in reputation and as a meeting place, where people
that are interested in theory or computer science, whether they are students, faculty, or someone else who is interested in theory of computer science, comes and meet. And of course, the good reputation of these days stems from all the fabulous speakers that we had here. So far, we had 65 invited speakers over the years. And this year, we are going to have six additional great speakers. Now, in the first session of the day, we will have Michal Feldman from Tel Aviv and Chandra Chakuri from the University of Illinois in Urbana-Champaign. This session will be chaired by Tamir Tassa, who, like all the session chairs of these days, is from here at the Open University. Then in the first afternoon session, we will have Noga Ron Zvi from Haifa University and Amos Fias from Tel Aviv University. And this session will be chaired by Menor Mendel. And finally, in the last session of the day, we have Merav Parter from Weizmann Institute and Avtali Tishbe from the Hebrew University. And their session will be chaired by Leonid Barenboim. So we really have a lot to look forward to. And at this point, I would like to invite the president of the Open University, Professor Mimi Eisenstadt, to say a few words.
Good morning and welcome. As you know, a university president is often being asked to open many academic conferences in a wide variety of topics. Moran and Tamir didn't give me lots of time, and only a few days after I was appointed as the president, they approached me and asked me to open this conference. And as very, very serious academic scholars, the invitation was not only an invitation, only an email, but they attached to it a reading list. And the reading list was links to previous conferences. And as serious academic scholar by myself, I actually have read and looked at the links, and I was very, very impressed. And after talking with Moran and Tamir, I was very, very impressed, as I said, from the conference. And the only problem that we have now as a university is that they set up a very, very high standard that it will not be easy to meet them in the next conferences that we will run. And it's not a surprise that they set up such high standards because our unit, our computer science department, mathematics and the computer science, is a very, very is working with high standards. We have excellent scholars, and I'm sure that everyone who is sitting here agree with me that as a president, I can be very, very proud with the scholars and the members of this unit. As a criminologist and the former dean of social work at the Hebrew University, I think you can imagine that I cannot, of course, contribute to your discussion today. But as a social scientist, I want to refer briefly to the question of the impact of computers on our daily life. And as we all know, a lot was written on the impact of social media on public opinion, for example, or in the area of Me Too, or on teaching and learning in the area of MOOCs and et cetera. But I want to add three examples which are not being discussed so much. And the first one, I want to refer to my Pilates class. the instructor last week asked us to move our neck like this, and she told us that she noticed that lately our neck muscles are becoming weak or stiff, as many of us do not use the head. We are not using the head to back up in the car because we are using the cameras in the cars, and it's going to. And she says that she's seeing it, that many of us are having problem to do this very, very minor move, but it's very interesting to think what will happen lately or in the future with this kind of muscles when we are not using them as much as we used before. Of course, there are issues of age and gender and social class, who is using these new cars and so on, but this is the social scientist issue. Another interesting phenomena. Another interesting phenomena is homeless people or beggars, which we see mainly in the big cities. While in the past, people stopped by. Some people, of course, stopped by and gave them some change they had in their pocket. Today, most of the money transition is done by credit cards or wire transition through various applications, and people do not have this money available in the pocket. And I've read an article that actually shows that they are suffering from our new way of transferring money. And again, this is something that we don't really think about it. And it raises interesting questions about the influence of the whole issue of applications and wire transition and so on. And finally, I want to refer to my area of therapeutic practice. And we know that the use of computers is changing medicine, especially time of big data and personalized medicine. But there is a big question which is being discussed quite a lot in the departments, especially of social work and psychology today, and which deals or ask questions about the impact of computer on this personal on the therapeutic sessions. Can the computer replace the social worker? Can it replace a psychologist? In a sense, yes. Sometime we already see that there are some ways of therapeutic sessions being done through the computer or via the computer, and it has its own effect and impact. On the other hand, the computer did not, or you people, did not find the way to replace empathy, which is it's something which is a very basic element in the whole therapeutic field. So I just wanted to kind of hint to some areas which I'm not sure that it's really being discussed, but as you can see, there are issues which can be of interest from very different points of view, and I'm sure that you are going to discuss very important issues here, and I really want to wish you an interesting conference today. I'm sorry that I have to deal with minor things like budget and manpower. So I'm sorry that I will not be able to stay, and thank you for everyone who has organized this conference, and have a good time.
So first of all, thanks to Mimi Eisenstadt, the president of the Open University, for speech and also for encouraging and supporting these events in general. I also would like to thank Mr. Asaf Shambi, who is from the events department, to help me to organize this theory day. And finally, special thanks to Tamir Tassa, who organized these days for the last 9 years before passing the torch to me. And he helped me a lot to get into his huge shoes, and I really would like to thank him for that. And now, without further ado, let me invite Tamir to chair the first session.